This is an assumptions question, and we have to find an assumption on which the argument depends. The conclusion is that payday loans through public sector banks should not be allowed. The missing link is between all the information presented and the conclusion that payday loans by public sector banks should not be allowed. Our broad expectation from the correct answer choice is that it strengthens this conclusion through a valid assumption. Let's look at the answer choices. Answer choice A, the public will be financially healthier if payday loans are entirely avoided. If this is so, it strengthens the conclusion that payday loans through public sector banks should not be allowed. However, even if this is a strengthening answer choice, it is not necessarily an assumption because it does not have to be true. In other words, even if infrequent payday loans are not harmful, they may be harmful beyond a certain point. And so the conclusion that payday loans from public sector banks should not be allowed may still hold. So this is not an assumption on which the argument depends. Let's eliminate this answer choice. Answer choice B, the public does not currently take the amount of payday loans that makes it detrimental for their financial health. If this is so, it means that the current financial health is not in risk. However, this answer choice makes no suggestion regarding the future financial health. So overall, this answer choice, if anything, faintly weakens rather than strengthens the conclusion. So let's eliminate this answer choice. Answer choice C, if payday loans were offered by public sector banks, the public would take more such loans. If this is so, it indicates that when the loans are offered by public sector banks, the public's financial health will be even riskier. So this answer choice strengthens the conclusion that the payday loans through public sector banks should not be allowed. Also, this answer choice does have to be true for the conclusion to hold, because negating this answer choice would mean that public would not take on more loans if the loans are offered by the public sector banks. In that case, the conclusion would be weakened. So this is a good answer choice. Let's keep this on hold. Answer choice D, the public prefers loan services from public sector banks than from private sector banks. If this is so, it indicates that public sector banks offering payday loans will lead to poorer financial health than private sector banks offering such loans. So this answer choice strengthens the conclusion that payday loans through public sector banks should not be allowed. However, despite being a fine strengthening statement, this answer choice does not have to be true for the conclusion to hold, because the conclusion may still hold even if there is no such preference. So this answer choice is not an assumption on which the argument depends. Let's eliminate this answer choice. Answer choice E, government should primarily be concerned with safeguarding the financial health of the public. If this is so, it means that payday loans which lead to overall health suffering should not be allowed by public sector banks. However, despite being a fine strengthening statement, this answer choice does not have to be true for the conclusion to hold, because the conclusion may still hold even if this is not the primary responsibility of the government. So long as the government is concerned with safeguarding the financial health, even if it's not its primary responsibility, the conclusion may still hold. So this answer choice is not an assumption on which the argument depends. Let's eliminate it. C is the correct answer choice.